My name is Genoveva Radeva. I'm a news producer and news anchor in Bulgarian national TV. I was a criminal reporter 10 years ago, and I can say that I'm fed up of bad news. I want to tell you something about my first official meeting with constructive journalism. A year ago, I attended a master class for constructive journalism of Eurovision Academy in Denmark. I had heard of this practice before, but I thought it just meant positive, cute news. With great interest, I listened to the lecture of Mr. Ulrich Haru. I'm sure that you know his name, the executive director of News at DR, the founder of Constructive Journalism, and his book, Constructive News, is my Bible, the Bible for my colleague too. And in Denmark, with even greater surprise, I found out that the approach which we have been trying to adopt in the last couple of years has its own name, constructive journalism. It turns out that we discovered this path ourselves in our desire to successfully fulfill our duty as a public media useful to the society. I will quote something of Mr. Hagrup. One definition which really impressed me. He said that traditional journalism is one-eye journalism. To produce, to manage constructive news, we have to open both our eyes, then the picture of life is different, vivid, colorful, real. To look at the world through other people's eyes. We thought, what if the others are blind? We faced the challenge to present the world through their eyes. We inspired them to rebel against the prejudices and barriers in our society. We provoked the institutions to solve the problems, and we inspire the viewers to help in this common fight. In the next couple of minutes, we will present our project, Electronic Eyes. The author, Maria Cherneva, is not an ordinary reporter. She is a true fighter for just causes, and the heroes of her stories are not whining blind people, those looking for compassion. No, they are fighters too. You will see some of them are so young, but they are fighters, people who change the rules and surpass all expectations. They are the people who hit the bullseye, and now you will see this. Maria, it's your turn.
I'm a little nervous for my English, and that's why I will read. Sorry. You know what? Everything is in its place now. I can be ruthless, I can be aggressive, and I can cut truth just by using words. I can fight cruel battles, and I have to, and I do it. I've been doing it for years, but the effect is questionable with a little satisfaction. This is why I always have tried another things. Like instead of cutting minister into a thin slice. I would just ask him to do what he promised, one or another way. However, this approach has nothing sensational about it. It is not exciting. This is not encouraging. It wins no awards. It is inglorious. Some even call it impotent, gutless. Even the CIRCOM Grand Prix jury criticized it. Now, things seem to have come back into their right place. There is definition, there is the field of action. We have been recognized. I'm doing constructive journalism. I feel better. Stella is a blind, just as the other archers. The Electronic Eyes campaign started with an archery competition between journalists and blind people. You will have to believe this. Several months before, a boy called Victor, blind by birth, he asked for help for his girlfriend Kalina. She is also completely blind. They live in a different neighborhoods and study in a local school. They refused the facilities of the school of the blind because didn't prepare them for the reality of life. Wow, it was amazed me from the first time. They wanted to be independent. They didn't want to have their parents take them from school. However, the street lights were a problem. The municipality had installed beeping street lights, but the last two got in a mess. The children fought the battle themselves. You must fight, actually, a battle with the municipal administration. All for the second time. There I was. I could do a sensitive coverage about the slugging and silly administration, which makes it difficult for the children to be independent. But I decided I wanted to talk about the incredible energy, initiative, and creativity of these two children, of their desire to change the environment instead of waiting for someone else to change it for them. I arranged a meeting between the children and the person who was in charge of the streetlights. It was not me. They showed him how important the missing streetlight was and how dangerous and confusing the other one was indeed.
Пресичането от двете страни ще бъде направено.
Да се направи начало, за да се знам двете платна на
парите. I think the man understood it was a huge mistake to do anything about the blind as he thinks fit without consulting them first. The issue of the two street lights was resolved, but the people living in the neighborhood started to breaking the buzzers on the street light. They couldn't sleep because of the noise, and the children got the idea that the concept itself should be changed. They shared the idea with the mayor of Sofia, and they were promised that a solution would be found, for example, by using another sound or by remote control. Different options were tested. Testing isn't over yet. In the meantime, Kalina and Viktor asked me to help them with another battle. They wanted to have their textbooks in a word format.
Желанието им да ходят на училище заедно с другите надмогва над трудностите им с учебниците. Виктор използва баба си за понеж учебник.
Разпространени предимно в равнинните територии.
Учебниците на Калина са пък МП тройки на стотици часове записи на баща им. Еферата на горящите програми и усилите на родителите им са нелепи, казват децата.
Ако е в формовски файл са ми учебник, доста по-лесно, то просто обработката си става както на зрящото и останалите.
И я да видя как се чете.
Ами ето как.
Почва разтегляне животни. Почва обрязва вашите фактори.
Сизателството обаче отрива на камък. Нито едно не иска да даде файлове. Затова децата настояват за среща с министерството.
Поемам ангажимент да поговорим с издателството. Става въпрос за достъп до образование.
Нашата среща предизвика проверка във всички училища в страната. Оказва се, че незрелите ученици в общообразователните училища са 67. И всички те имат проблеми с учебниците. Така че битката на Виктор и Калина вече е и за тях.
Трябва да се разговаря до сега момент, като не трябва да имам картинки.
Да не имам две колонки, защото това също във връзка с четете.
Моята идея е да се направи на сайта на Министерството, се събират всички учебници и се прави регистрационна форма.
Намерили сте, потърсили сте или поне са помислили за някакво решение?
Ние наистина за някои неща не сме и предполагали, че може има такива проблеми.
И в същото време си давам благодарен съвет колко е трудно да си различен в България.
Два месеца по-късно електронните учебници вече са факти са изпратени на техните мейли. Виктор и Калина не могат да си намерят място от радост. Първи се оказа, че е по история и Виктор веднага потърси урока си за утре. С помощта на говорящи програми те ще четат уроците си толкова бързо, колкото и са учениците им и като тях ще могат да учат по всяко време.
Да си го прочетеш, а не да се зависиш
по всяко време. Може да си го прочетеш в 11 часа преди да си легнеш. Може баба ти да мие чини.
Виктор и Калина сами предизвикаха промяната, от която има нужда. Укрилени от успеха си, сега ще мислят как да преодолеят останалите си зависимости.
Amazing children, yes. They want to be free. They want to be free to move around without help. I admire their ability to use the new technologies, PC, smartphones, and the puzzle put itself together somehow. It was about the need for a new talking application to the smartphones that would give them. I check, it is completely possible, and it will be not cost so much. And the name of the campaign popped by itself, electronic or digitalized. In fact, it would have been easy for me to raise 15,000 level, approximately 8,000 euro. I could go to one or two big donors, but I decided it should be an SMS campaign, fundraising campaign, using one donor number. I wanted everyone to participate in the change and to see through the cliché that blind people were unfit and pitiful and that they need protection only. This is how the idea of the competition was born too. This is only a video of the competition. There is an archery sport club and yes, the blind can learn archery. And I wonder if you guess who won the competition, the blind or the journalist. They were actually leading TV broadcasters, famous TV anchors and journalists, or the blind. What do you think? The blind. Actually. And then we spoke about Misu, who was auto mechanics and who simply heard where the engine trouble is. There is also Mitko, who repairs computers. Blind Georgi, the popular philosophy teacher. And again, the problem with these positive stories was that fundraising was too slow. Blind Ivan gave another idea. He wanted to challenge everyone to making a parachute jump. I will spare you all the trouble of how we got it organized, but we did it on air. And during the broadcast, we got quite a lot of fundraising calls.
Там горе, заедно с птиците, разбираш, че само свободата има значение, че няма непреодолимо ограничение, че зависимостите са продукт единствено на собствените ни страхове. Иван реши да предизвика съдбата си, поиска да направи нещо немислимо, да победи и себе си, да изпита възможностите си, да докаже и на себе си и на другите, че няма непреодолими бариери, когато другът е свободен. И успя.
Аз всъщност две победи имам. На себе си и съм много доволен. А иначе не мога да ти опиша това, което не може, което тя си живее само.
Просто ще знам наистина давам много вяра в себе си и вяра в неизвестното, т.е. гледаме по-лесно в бъдещето.
Искам да кажа всички, вярвайте в себе си, гледайте багерите, които са и в главите, защото много прекалено много стереотипи имаме, които наистина само ни печат.
Предизвикателствата са за страховете, които всеки трябва да преодолее. Едно от посланията на кампанията електронно учи, което днес среща много подкрепа.
Up till now we have raised all money we needed. We succeed to convince the municipality to give us real-time data about the urban transport. And had the CIRCOM conference been in a month's time, I could have demonstrated to you the talking application. The apps would have been in the hands of the blind people so that they could complete that we started. Change the reality, break the deformed image we have about them as being unfit, destroyed reality, building stereotypes and the media are to blame about it. So with their slobbery but powerful stories about the blind people, with the missing stories about all those who lead a normal life in spite of everything. But the way we could have raised all the money in no time by showing one or two slobbery stories about feeble blind children. However, they would only have embedded the cliché. Anyway, I'm so happy that some producers from my television trusted me in whoever made it. Actually, the constructive approach is being applied even more often. And since refugees will be a hot topic here, a word about them. We entered in the international exchange with civilian formation detaining illegally and beating up refugees, and since this was the only topic that entered in the international exchange, you might think this is what we do. Now let me show you the rest of the picture. The inhabitants of the border villages, Chtitz, Lodun and Matachina, meet with illegal refugees every day. They're thirsty and hungry, so the local give them accommodation first, offer them bread and water, and then they call the border authorities. This is what happens more often, not the beating. And this is also part of the constructive approach, and it remind us that we are a nation of refugees and that we should better change our negative attitude to migrants. We simply recollect our own history. After the liberation, Bulgaria accepted hundreds of thousands of refugees. After the World War I and World War II, and after the Armenian genocide, we didn't the same. And the ones that are crumbling now are most probably their progeny.
Thank you, Maria. Do you have any questions about this case? I have at least one. Maria, how difficult it was to persuade managers, the leaders of newsroom, to support your strategy of a little bit slower, a little bit more steps toward aim?
Actually, this not was too difficult because I have a lot of experience with those campaigns, but more often, you know, because this story with not a such a big success, they put it maybe later, broadcast later.
But they did it. But they did it. And are other colleagues now more interested in that kind of concept of working?
What?
Other colleagues, are they also now interested in some kind of strategies following some stories like you did?
Yes, I did. I think so.
Thank you. Thank you very much for showing the possibilities of the change of approach. Do you have any more questions? Then please say once more thank you for our colleagues. Well, thank you very much.